Good morning, everyone. So you know we are discussing about the applications of dimensional methods. The first application is to convert one system of unit into another system of unit, where we are using n1 u1 is equal to n2 u2. The second application is to check the correctness of given equation by applying principle of homogeneity. Okay, and now the third application is to derive the relation between given physical quantities. So you will be given some physical quantities and you have to derive the relation between that physical quantities. Okay, now so first example is find the expression for centripetal force. Find the expression for centripetal force acting on a particle of mass m moving with velocity v along a circular path of radius small r. Okay, find the expression for, find the relation between centripetal force acting on a particle of mass m moving with velocity v along a circular path of radius small r. For that you have to take the centripetal force F is proportional to m power a velocity power b radius to the power c. Okay, so now we have to find the values of a, b, c in terms of dimensions, because a, b, c are the dimensions among. Okay, so F proportional to m power a v power b r power c. So F is equal to some constant k into m power a v power b r power c. Now you can take the value of k as 1 in any one of the system, that is CG system or SI system, you can take the value of k as 1. So now dimension formula for force is mlt power minus 2 and dimension formula for mass is m to the power a. Dimension formula for velocity is lt power minus 1 to the power b and dimension formula for radius is l to the power c. So now mlt power minus 2 is equal to m power a, here l power b, l power c. When bases are equal you can add the powers, therefore you can take l to the power of b plus c and t power minus b. Okay, so now equating the dimensions of the same physical quantities LHS and RHS amount. Okay, so now you are taking this as m to the power of 1. So if you are writing m, you can take that as m to the power of 1 is equal to m power a. So when these are equal, you can equate these dimensions, then a is equal to 1. Okay, now here t power minus 2 equal to t power minus b. So that means minus 2 equal to minus b, minus minus gets cancelled, you will get b is equal to 2. Okay, and comparing l power 1 is equal to l to the power b plus c. So here 1 is equal to b plus c, where b is equal to 2. Therefore you can take 1 is equal to 2 plus c, from that you will get c is equal to minus 1. Okay, now substituting these values in this equation, f is equal to m power 1 v power 2 r power minus 1. Okay, so r power minus 1 you can take to the denominator as 1 by r amount. So therefore the centripetal force acting on a particle of mass m moving with velocity v around a circular path of radius r is given by f is equal to mv square by r. So this is the relation between these given physical quantities amount. So it's nothing but just derivation of a formula. So s is equal to ut plus half at square, you can derive that formula. Okay, so like that, to derive the relation between the given physical quantities, we are using this dimensional method. Okay, and second example, deduce the relation between velocity of a sound wave v traveling in a medium of density d having modulus of elasticity capital E. Okay, so density and modulus of elasticity are the two parameters of a medium required for a sound wave to travel. Okay, so velocity of sound wave v, density of medium d, modulus of elasticity of medium capital E. Okay, so now you can take v directly proportional to d power a e power b. So v is equal to constant k into d power a e power b. So velocity dimension formula lt power minus 1 is equal to, this constant value is taken as 1. Density dimension formula ml power minus 3 whole to the power a. Modulus of elasticity is nothing but stress sum, where stress can be taken as force by area, whose dimensional formula is ml power minus 1 t power minus 2 whole to the power b. Okay, now lt power minus 1 is equal to m power a plus b, l power minus 3a minus b, t power minus 2b. So just we have taken the summation of the dimensions of same physical quantities. Okay. Now t power minus 1 equal to t power minus 2b. That means minus 1 equal to minus 2b and b is equal to 1 by 2. So we have found the value of b. Similarly, m power 0. If there is nothing dimensions for m, you can take that as m power 0. So something power 0 is equal to we cannot define that. So m power 0 is equal to m to the power a plus b. Okay, so that implies a plus b equal to 0, a is equal to minus b. Or you can equate l power 1 is equal to l power minus 3a minus b, and you can find the value of a amount. So that is a is equal to minus 1 by 2. So writing v is equal to e power 1 by 2 d power minus 1 by 2. So this 1 by 2 can be considered as root amount. Okay, so e power 1 by 2 by d power 1 by 2, where we can take that as v is equal to under root of e by d. So that means the velocity of a sound wave is directly proportional to square root of modulus of elasticity and inversely proportional to square root of density of the medium. So velocity of sound wave to travel in a medium, it depends on modulus of elasticity and density of medium. So this is the relation between these three physical quantities. Okay, so like that you can find relation between physical quantities by taking some examples, like t is equal to 2 pi root of l by g, or you can take few examples. Okay, so after this, the last topic of this dimensional constant is limitations of dimensional methods amount. Okay, so limitations of dimensional methods means, first one, this method is not applicable for dimensionless constants. So dimensionless constants are the constants which do not have any dimensional formula, like angle, strain, relative density. All these are the quantities which do not have any dimensional formula. So this method is not applicable for dimensionless constants. And the second one is, it fails if the equation consisting of more than two physical quantities amount. So that means s is equal to ut plus half a t square. So that equation is consisting only two terms. So if the equation contains more than two terms, then we cannot apply this dimensional method to find the relation. Okay. And third one is, this is not applicable to the equations which involve trigonometric functions, logarithmic functions, okay, exponential functions among. So this is not applicable for trigonometric functions, exponential functions and logarithmic functions. And fourth one, it is not applicable if the equation has some odd difference of more than two physical quantities. Okay, so first one is not applicable for dimensionless constant, not applicable for equation having more than two terms, not applicable for trigonometric, logarithmic and exponential terms, and not applicable for the equation having some odd difference more than two physical quantities. Okay, so these are limitations of dimensional methods amount. Thank you.